Hello students, in this chapter we are going to learn more about Maria Sharapova, how she dreamt of achieving something and what efforts did she make to achieve her dreams. It's another inspiring story that we had read. Chapter Reach for the Top, Part 2, Maria Sharapova. Maria Sharapova's story of success as she became the top-seeded woman tennis player in the world motivates us. She overcame all the hurdles and bore humiliation too in order to achieve her dream. Maria's hunger for success and her competitive spirit kept her going. So you might have read about Maria Sharapova, how she had been on the tennis field and what did she achieve in her life. She has won 5 Grand Slam titles. There is something disarming about Maria Sharapova, something at odds with her ready, smiling, glamorous attire. And that something in her lifted her on Monday, 22nd August 2005, to the world number one position in women's tennis. So in women's tennis, she had been marked as a great player. All this happened in almost no time. Poised beyond her age. Mark the word here. Poised beyond her age, the Siberian-born teenager took just 4 years as a professional to reach the pinnacle. Poised is calm and elegant. A pinnacle is the most successful position. There is something quite different about her. Okay, the quality in contrast to Maria Sharapova's smile and glamour, which makes her likable. It is this quality that helped her achieve success as she attained world number one position in women's tennis on Monday, August 22, 2005. Now, Maria's calmness and elegance is beyond her age. She was born in Siberia, Russia, and as a teenager, she took only 4 years of training to become the top-seeded woman tennis player. However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before, with a level of sacrifice few children would be prepared to endure. Now, what is the sacrifice that she had to do? And why is it so? Little Maria had not yet celebrated her 10th birthday when she was packed off to train in the United States. That trip to Florida with her father Yuri launched her on the path to success and stardom. But it also required a heart-wrenching 2-year separation from her mother Yelena. The latter was compelled to stay back in Siberia because of visa restrictions, and this is how her mother could not join them and go to US. The 9-year-old girl had already learned an important lesson in her life. So this is where we can mark that she had learned the most important lesson of her life, and that was that tennis excellence would only come at a price. Okay, so this was something that she was not prepared for. And she learned the most important lesson in her life. What happens then? However, the rapid ascent in a fiercely competitive world began 9 years before the level of sacrifice the few children would be prepared to endure. But it was her hard work and efforts that helped her achieve so many things in her life, including the topmost position in the field of tennis. Ascent here means growth. Endure means to suffer patiently. The fast growth of her career started 9 years ago when she had made a big sacrifice. She was not a big girl as yet, but still she had to sacrificed so many things in her life. She had not even turned 10 when she was sent to Florida, US, with her father. And after the separation from her mother, she tried to be alone and self-reliant. So self-reliance came with great sacrifice. And this is what she thought was the greatest lesson in her life. Maria's mother was forced to stay back in Siberia because she did not have the permit to travel to US. And at the tender age of 9, Maria learned that in order to excel at tennis, she would have to make many sacrifices. So after reading something about her like this, we can really draw a contrast between how Santosh had to strive hard to make her parents understand what she was interested in doing and why she should be permitted to do so. And here on the other hand, we can see that Maria had to leave her home and her parents in order to achieve something in her life. "I missed my mother terribly," she says. "My father was working as much as he could to keep my tennis training going, so he couldn't see me either." Now, Maria recollects that she used to remain alone and missed her mother a lot, and her father worked hard to fetch money for her needs, and so he also could not meet her. "And because I was so young, I used to go to bed at 9 p.m. So this is something that she recollects and shares. And what did she do? Instead of letting that sacrifice or separation depress her, she tried to overcome it. "Instead of letting that depress me, I became more quietly determined and mentally tough. I learned how to take care of myself. I never thought of quitting because I knew what I wanted." So this is where you can conclude that she was strong-headed and strong-willed, and she did not think about quitting, but she strived hard to do something that could make her mentally tough. Though Maria Sharapova speaks with a pronounced American accent, she proudly parades her Russian nationality. Okay, so in her interview, as the interviewer could mark that although she can speak in English, she has not forgotten her Russian nationality, and she pronounces American accent quite fluently. So though Maria Sharapova speaks with pronounced American accent, she highlights the Russian nationality. "Clearing all doubt," she says, "I'm Russian. It's true that the US is a big part of my life, but I have Russian citizenship." Okay, so you can mark it here. "My blood is totally Russian. I will play the Olympics for Russia if they want me." So in her interview, she stated something like this, and she is proud to be a Russian. Like any number of teenage sensations, Maria Sharapova lists fashion, singing and dancing as her hobbies. So apart from playing tennis, she is also fond of singing, dancing, and she also has a lot other things to do during her leisure time, as she has great interest in reading books. And she loves reading the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle. So you can mark the same in your textbook. So this is something we can know about Maria Sharapova as we read the chapter. Read the chapter and try to answer the questions listed in the textbook.